All right, good morning, you guys. It is time for your health check. We start with good news for pregnant women who wish to protect themselves against COVID-19. New data published in the New England Journal of Medicine shows the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines do not appear to pose any serious risk during pregnancy. The CDC says pregnant women who get COVID-19 are at an increased risk for any severe illness. It may be also at increased risk for adverse outcomes, for instance, preterm birth. That's if you get the illness itself. So this study suggests the benefits of the vaccines really do outweigh the risks. If you're feeling sore after your vaccine, you know, at the injection site, an expert at Johns Hopkins explains why.
And one of the reasons we have specifically arm pain with vaccines is because we're giving these vaccines in an amount of liquid into areas where you have muscle. So there's not a lot of space for that liquid to go. And as you stretch those muscle fibers that you're injecting the vaccine into, that can be painful. And it can take a while for that to go down.
I'm so glad she explained that. Finally, someone making sense of it all. Also, the severity of your reaction, by the way, has nothing to do with the efficacy of the vaccine. So, for instance, if you didn't have any side effects, that doesn't mean that it didn't work. Just consider yourself lucky. About 50 million people around the world have some form of dementia, and there are limited treatment options right now. But a new pilot study out of Belgium shows combining exercise and actually video gaming really can make a difference. The training improves lower extremity and cognitive function, as well as reaction time and symptoms of depression. There's also research linking lack of sleep to dementia. Jason Miles connects these dots.
New research suggests getting too little sleep can increase your risk of dementia. Let's connect the dots. The link between poor sleep and dementia is nothing new, but what was not clear was whether that lack of sleep was a symptom of cognitive decline or one of the causes. Now a large new study suggests that people who don't get enough shut-eye in their 50s and 60s are more likely to develop dementia later in life. The study was published in the journal Nature. It followed nearly 8,000 people for decades. Researchers found that people who regularly reported getting 6 hours or less of sleep on weeknights were close to 30% more likely to be diagnosed with dementia nearly 3 decades later. That's compared to people who reported getting 7 hours or more a night. So how can you catch more Z's? While doctors say sleeping pills are an okay temporary solution, they don't give you the deep sleep needed. Also, naps are okay, but also a sign you're not getting the shut-eye you need at night. Instead, keep a regular sleep schedule, avoid caffeine and alcohol before bed, and keep the phone and screens out of the bedroom.